Kind thanks go to Surfshark VPN for sponsoring today's episode. Today I'll explain to you what a Block 3 Starship is and why the tests are feeling so rushed right now, and what's next for Super Heavy, Orbital Starships, and the next phase of the development program.
What about it? Go for launch.
We're go for launch. Let's light this candle.
Ignition sequence start.
My name is Felix, and I am your host for today's episode of What About It? And as always, there's been a lot going on in the space industry lately, so let's dive right in. Starship updates. Do you know what's changing in SpaceX's Boca Chica, Texas? They are secretly transitioning into the next generation of Starships, and while everyone is glued to the latest generation of Starship prototypes right now, we'll take a look ahead. And rightfully so, as here is where the action is right now. Mary, as always, right in the middle and providing us with some absolutely stunning pictures. After the two successful Starship launches in early December and February, SpaceX is already preparing for the next launch. Starship serial number 10 has successfully passed the first cryogenic test, and we're just waiting for them to do some static fires. But why is that? Why is SpaceX seemingly pushing through these prototypes so fast? It almost looks like they'd be rushing it. As if the last few Starships were speed builds with little care for detail. As if they could just waste them. Comments about SpaceX never succeeding with the Starship program are ramping up again after every failed landing attempt. I feel like back in the early days of the Dirt Hill and the dented Mark 1 Starship, when reading through all those replies to my episodes felt rough at times. So I started looking into it. Why does it seem like SpaceX would be wasting these Starships to so many of us right now? As so often, there's some truth to it. In a sense, these comments are correct. You're right when feeling that these Starships are being rushed. It's part of the plan. Starship serial number 8 all the way through to 11 are a batch of prototypes. All of them fairly similar and all of them built in quick succession. To understand what SpaceX's plan is, we have to look at the bigger picture. Do you remember these four brave prototypes? Those were Starship serial number 3 to 6. All of them fairly similar, all of them for one purpose only. Quickly built with almost no difference, and many were wondering why none of them had a nose cone, why none of them received flaps. That's because they had a different purpose. To do that first 150 meter hop. Two suffered a fatal anomaly in the pre-flight test campaigns and two made it. Processes were refined and procedures leading up to a launch were improved until it worked out twice in a row. And a chapter of prototypes was closed. Here we are now with fully built Starships. Flaps, nose cones, stumpy legs, and we're seeing the same thing all over again. To understand the concept behind all this and to be one step ahead of the comments saying that SpaceX will never succeed, we must understand that Starships SN8 through SN11 are not just a continuation of the development, where every prototype gradually changes. Instead, they are a family of prototypes inside a larger plan of building operational Starships. They are the first batch to try and perform a high-altitude flight test, if possible, including a landing. Looking at SpaceX's FALCON rocket development, we can see a similar picture. They are divided into generations, different batches. FALCON 1 being the demonstrator. Can we get a payload into orbit? FALCON 9 V1.0 being the first to have the 9-engine design. No legs yet and quite a few differences compared to the later versions. Then came V1.1. Legs appeared and grid fins. First landing attempts were made, while also keeping SpaceX alive by serving customers. V1.2 improved on it. Full thrust. To be precise, 17% more thrust due to cryogenic cooling of the propellant. An improved stage separation system. A stretched upper stage. Then, in 2018, came Block 5, the Falcon 9 we know today. A lot of minor refinements that collectively were very important. Upgraded thrust and improved legs. And if we extrapolate this approach and apply it to the Starship program, where are we at? What improvements are to come? When will we see them? Luckily, we have Mauricio from RGB Aerial Photography, and luckily he regularly does a flyover reporting back the latest pictures from Boca Chica. Follow him on Twitter and become a flight supporter on Patreon, he deserves it. Major upgrades slated for serial number 15. Musk has already said it back in late 2020. Since serial number 12 and 14 have been cancelled, this will be the next batch, the first Starship of a new generation, Starship prototype Block 3, so to speak. If we stick to the block idea, what will this next block of Starships do differently? If you look closer at Mauricio's footage, you can already see a few things. In one single picture, there are so many indicators for the next generation. We have the serial number 16 thrust section. The thrust pug is visible from above. One large O2 inlet in the middle and three methane inlets surrounding it. The current generation of thrust pugs, as seen in one of Mary's wonderful videos, shows a crucial difference in the design. It has six inlets surrounding the middle, three for methane and three for O2, supplying propellant and oxidizer to each of the three Raptor engines. On the new thrust pug design, SpaceX took out a lot of complexity. O2 is being routed through the pug through a central inlet in the middle. This reduces weight and complexity. The best part is no part. We also have serial number 16's aft section, including the legs on site. It's largely the same design as on serial number 8 to 10. Comparing a shot from Steve Jurvetson of serial number 9 inside the high bay just before it fell over and gave serial number 9 the nickname Eileen, and a shot from Mary from NASA Spaceflight of the serial number 16 leg skirt, we can see that they are 99% identical. This gives us another valuable clue as to what the next batch of Starships is supposed to do. It's not going to be orbital. With the next generation, SpaceX will likely attempt the same thing. High altitude flight tests and perfecting the landings. Serial number 15 through 18 will likely not go orbital. On we go with a few other very interesting items in the picture. We have the forward dome for a super heavy booster with that strange hexagonal shape attached. It's still unknown as to what its purpose will be, but it could be the resting structure for the Starships to be stacked on top. There will also need to be an attachment interface, couplers for fuel and oxidizer, and pushers for a separation. We also have a thrust section of a super heavy booster, including a four-engine thrust pug. A huge hole in the middle and outlets and anchor points for four Raptor engines. As seen from the ground, these super heavy thrust domes also have holes on the dome itself and a massive amount of structural bracing as seen by all the welds surrounding the thrust pug. Also, a massive ring on the outside of the engine skirt with holes in it of unknown purpose can be seen. This picture is a treasure trove. Right in the middle of all this, we have a forward dome assembly, but it looks strangely flat. The jig is about half the height of the standard forward dome next to it. Musk has stated before that one of his goals is to create a flat forward dome to be able to make more space inside the fairing section usable. This might be an early prototype. Right under serial number 16's aft section, we have some carefully arranged metal structures. We don't know for sure, but it looks like a preparation for a stand of some sort. Its diameter is bigger than that of a Starship or Super Heavy booster, though. And it reminds me a bit of this strange stand that's been sitting at the High Bay Plaza for a while now on its own foundation. Purpose also unknown, but this might be related to Super Heavy boosters, to give the taller hull a wider stance while construction is being done. So, what did we learn from analyzing Mauricio's treasure map? Starships 15 through 18 will test different thrust pugs, have the same landing legs as the current generation, likely with the same purpose of performing a landing from a high altitude flight, and we might see a test tank with a flat dome in the future. The upcoming Starship generation is likely not going to go to orbit. It will be all about weight reduction, reducing complexity, and becoming more reliable. It's unknown if the new generation of Starships will utilize the 3mm steel tested with Test Tank 7.2 right now, which would be another major change. SpaceX is building generations of Starship prototypes rather than single test candidates, each generation improving on the last one and each batch of Starships benefiting from the previous one with better build quality and a faster build cadence. What do you think about the idea of using block numbers to track major Starship evolutions? Tell me in the comments.
Great success!
The Y family needs your support. Give the video a like, subscribe, and share it with your friends on Twitter or Facebook to show the YouTube algorithm that you appreciate the content. Gain access to our Discord server where you can meet me and the rest of the team or get a completely ad-free release of each and every episode provided just for members. Or do you know about the Y warehouse? Shop for your next Starship shirt and look as awesome as you feel. Links can be found in the description. You rock! And at the launch site, the next block phase is showing as well. SpaceX is giving some massive improvements to the landing pad. SpaceX is learning quickly. After two Starship crashes and two needed repair jobs, SpaceX is stepping up the game. Each time a Starship crashes on the pad, SpaceX workers are forced to cut out a piece of the pad and replace it with a patch of new concrete. This is likely due to the fact that cracks form in the pad created by the force of the impact, which go all the way through it. Now the plan seems to be to double the strength to make the pad withstand Starship crashes. A new layer of concrete is being put on the pad, signaled by lots of rebar surrounding the middle. Moving further up to the orbital launch mount, Mauricio's aerial pictures give us the perfect view on new piling work. SpaceX is placing six more large piles into the ground in a hexagonal shape, quite like the orbital launch mount itself. This time though, with less diameter and slightly thinner. My current bet is that this will be the long-awaited stacking tower Musk has been talking about. Or is it a water tower? And finally, looking at the construction between Orbital Launch Mount and Highway 4, we can see first signs of proper fuel storage tanks being erected. Four circular concrete foundations are going up, which can only mean one thing. SpaceX is erecting four new massive tank foundations in preparation for the Fuel Farm 2.0, directly connected to the Orbital Launch Mount. SpaceX is getting ready for Super Heavy tests and for the Block 4 Starship prototypes to be tested here after Starship serial number 18. There's always a method behind what SpaceX is doing. Even though it might seem rushed and without a plan behind it, there's a reason why Starships crash into the landing pad over and over again, and only a look ahead can tell us why. Now let's have a look at today's sponsor, and don't click away just yet, the deal is actually pretty sweet. Whether it's data and identity theft, traceability, intrusive advertising, or geo-blocking, Surfshark VPN encrypts your data and enables you to change your virtual location. Have you ever been greeted with a message that this site or video is not available in your country? Streaming services like Netflix or Disney Plus, for example, have vastly different libraries in different countries. Surfshark makes you outsmart them easily by removing the so-called geo-block from your account. Just activate your VPN, change your virtual location, refresh the page, and you're good to go for countless more Netflix evenings. Use my code to get 83% off plus 3 extra months for free and at the same time support What About It. Surfshark offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there is no risk. Surf with your own set of rules, links in the description. Today's YouTube member and Patreon shoutout goes to SVBBVLB, Jacob Maxton, Justini, Stephen O'Leary, and many others. You rock! Thank you so much for your support. We're currently at 1,444 supporters, which to me is a mind-blowing number. Thank you for enabling us to do all this, and don't forget to join us in our Discord server. Today's team shoutout goes to Split Second Mom, my wife. Yes, I can do that, because she's been with me and the team since day one. She's been supportive of our crazy plans from the beginning on, and she's been there whenever we needed someone to lend a helping hand. Hosting shows, managing the team, doing captions, and poking her nose in wherever she could, she's one of the most awesome team members we have. So, thank you, honey. I love you.
Let's kick some ice.
Directly connected to the orbital... launch mount. Ah, okay. So farced. So farced. As if. Okay, once more.